prior. So sorry from my side. And with that, you can start. Like, sorry for the, delays.
Fine. Hello everyone. So we are back again yet with our yet another live. So I'm very excited to introduce you all to our today's guest speaker, who is Dr. Samriti Sharma. So she's a functional medicine practitioner and she's been building tools to transform lives. You can check out her page. She's been helping out people resolve health issues, making them aware of different health issues. And so yeah, today she'll be helping us with a very vast topic, which is gut health and how gut is affecting our overall body. So before we go ahead, I'll just give a little introduction to our viewers about yesterday's live, which was about building immunity. So yesterday, our Ayurveda doctor spoke about how eating habits and the food we eat affects us. So I feel this gut health session, ma'am, that you'll be taking ahead will really be beneficial for all of us to now know how we can manage our gut health and how it will be affecting us.
So just to start, because there were so many people who were interested to know about the gut health, and it's a new word. It's something that we don't, talk much about when it comes to health, because there are so many other dimensions of health that we're already talking, right? Like physical health, mental health, and spiritual health. But there is a very least sight to see about the gut health. And it's very shocking that whatever is happening inside us, each moment is being regulated by our own gut. So that's something why I always talk about gut health in any session, and why people should actually know about it. Because when even COVID came, I personally feel people who've been on, long terms of antibiotics, any kind of, diet and lifestyle they were initially into, I think gut was something that was still underrated. There were so many doctors who were still not talking about it. Just asking them to eat, protein is not enough. I personally feel from my side that, when you talk about gut, you need to tell the audience that gut is something that is going to regulate each and every factor in your body, whether it's an internal factor, whether it's an external factor. By internal factors, I just mean creating energy, digestion, assimilation, absorbing things, then obviously eliminating all the bad stuff. So, what we humans currently are doing right now is we are initially absorbing a lot, a lot. And in this a lot, I mean not just the food, but definitely whatever is, absorption really. It's something that I often say here is that gut health and gut feeling, they are working on the similar aspect, right? It's just because, see, whatever we feel today with the help of media, or probably you can say with the help of what we are seeing or maybe hearing, or maybe any sense that gets activated, there is a part of us that is absorbing everything in our subconscious mind also. So now this is just a part that is also included in our gut health, but the majority of things come from what we eat. So because this is what I even say that, whatever you're absorbing, whatever you're eating is your gut, and this is being reflected in your hair, your skin, probably your eyes. You might see some people, they're so glowy, they have got such beautiful eyes, such beautiful smile. So, question comes there that how that person is, initially maintaining. So that's not maintaining, that's something that your body is properly digesting. It's absorbing things and it's flushing out the bad. And when you flush out the bad bacteria from your gut, eventually you have to re-inoculate also the good stuff. So aisa nahi hai ki aaj aap sab kuch flush out kar denge, like all the toxins will move out, and you don't give space for the good bacteria to grow back. It's not, and one thing that I often get asked, ki bad bacteria, like it shouldn't be there, it should be neutralized. Nahin, aisa zaruri nahin hai. There is an activity that a lot of good people who know about gut perform. Jaise jab hum chote hote the, we used to, do this mud picking, okay? Why it was done? Because the reason being, आर गट हेल्थ ऑल्सो नीड्स टू गेट रेगुलेटेड रेगुलेटेड इन द सेंस आपकी बॉडी में इतने सारे मैकेनिजम्स हैं राइट रेस्पिरेटरी इज देयर देन द एक्सक्रीशन मैकेनिज्म एनी थिंग दैट हेल्प्स योर बॉडी इन रेगुलेटिंग ऑल द मैकेनिज्म दोज एक्टिविटीज कैन बी गुड फॉर यू राइट एंड यहाँ पे एक आई रियली वॉन्ट टू से दिस वन थिंग कि जो छोटे बच्चे होते हैं ना दे आर वेरी मच एक्टिव विद एवरी थिंग दे डोंट रिस्ट्रिक्ट देमसेल्व फ्रॉम ईटिंग from playing into the bad, you know, and now what our generation has shifted on that side is ki hum logo ko, we need very much clean things, you know, but sometimes these act of doing mud picking and all these generate bad bacteria and our gut regulates on that mechanism. So it's like we have paused our mechanism. Hume kuch set of do's and don'ts bata diye hain. Now the don'ts never happen. So just understand our body's never being, faced with these kind of things. So you're eating the bad, but you're not giving the good. Or either you're giving too much of good, but you're not eating anything bad. so both the things mm-hmm. need to be in balance. That is what I meant by gut health. Ki aap jo bhi absorb kar rahe hain, whether it's food, whether it's your lifestyle, whether it's physical activity, or any kind of, any kind of activity that is making you easy on your, maybe it could be 1 hour of walk, maybe it could be 1 hour of cycling, 1 hour of just sitting outside in the balcony, that could really help you flush out a lot of bad toxins that are accumulating. And yahan pe people really ask me this thing, ki ye kaise relate hota hai? Matlab, how this gut thing gets related to our emotions. Simple hai yaar, matlab, aapka gut jo hai, it's entirely a, a part of your body. Okay, now whatever emotions you will give, or whatever you'll feel or absorb, your gut has receptors into it. These receptors will obviously send your glands the signal to operate. Aap logon ne observe kiya hoga kafi bari, like I take it in a stretch, sorry, because the reason being when it goes in flow, people are able to understand much better. So
yeah, that
right. So why I just pinpointed this thing out, because aapke jo glands hote hain wo decide karte hain ki aapka jo hormone level hai wo zyada hona chahiye ya kam hona chahiye, right? So until and unless you are not giving your glands that kind of environment to operate, har kisi ka apna ek environment hai. Until and unless aapki body ko environment nahi mil raha, whether it's from the good bacteria and the bad bacteria, jise hum bolte hain na, plus and minus neutralizes, right? Negative, negative, it always be nothing. So that is the picture, that once you give your body the right environment, your gut the right environment, you would be able to have the glands working. And jab aapki glands properly work karte hain, your hormones also get secreted in a balanced amount. Nahi to kya hoga, kabhi ek hormone zyada ho jayega, kabhi ek hormone kam ho jayega. Like simply estrogen and progesterone, which are so important for a girl, to have good quality of hair. Biotin is one, then melatonin is one. People have really not talked about melatonin also, where I personally feel ki agar aapka, you are stressed, you are sleep deprived at one point of time. So the stress and cortisol levels, both the things get very high. And because of that, aapki hair loss ki jo ek speed hai, wo normal se bahut zyada proceed kar jati hai. And I've seen people having it. So people, I think medically, we have got a lot of terms for these, conditions. But ek bahut simple si cheez hai, if you're balancing everything out in your body, it could result in a good quality of hair, good quality of skin. Everything goes in picture. So that's something why gut health is important.
Right. And, a lot of people think that they've been eating right, they've been following a healthy diet, but still their gut is not well. So do you think healthy eating will also mean that you have a healthy gut? Like, I don't
definitely.
Think it
definitely. Definitely.
Okay. So we have a couple of questions coming in. Would you want to take it now? Or
I think at the end of the session, we would... maybe you can just proceed with that.
Sure. So somebody has asked, also would like to know about foods that help flushing out bad bacteria from the gut.
Yeah. So there are lots and lots of, food. Maybe I can say these are not... these won't help you in flushing, but these will help you in maintaining the balance and give you a way out for the good bacteria to grow back, right? Now, these could be xenofoods. These could be functional foods also. And trust me, we don't need to work on things like aapko online jaake ek bahut acha sa jaggery ka, you know, you have to order something. There are so many things, there are so many options available in your own kitchen. And I call it as kitchen pharmacy always, because God has granted us such a beautiful pharmacy at our homes, and that is our kitchens. So we find, or you know, we are always looking for something that is out. But really, things have been there in your own kitchen. Like, you can start including things like these herbal, you know, like turmeric is there, you know, ashwagandha is there, elaichi is there. So these are those things that will help you promote each and every function of your body. And this results in good secretion of hormones, right? So with food, what you can do is high amount of protein always needs to be included in your diet, right? If you don't have enough amount of protein, your cells won't be able to function well. And definitely the amount of energy, or maybe, you know, when we talk about, you know, the process of how a hair is being grown back, or maybe how it grows long. There is an entire phase of it, right? There is a phase of degeneration and there's a phase of regeneration. Then definitely a fully grown follicle, like everything comes in a picture only when it has the right environment. So even same happens with your hair also. People ask about biotin. Biotin is something that definitely works, but it won't work जब तक उसको एक प्रॉपर डाइट, लाइफस्टाइल, स्लीप, एवरीथिंग कम्स इन पिक्चर व्हेन यू आर यूजिंग एनी काइंड ऑफ सप्लीमेंट. एंड इवन दिस हैपेंस आई थिंक त्रया, विद त्रया हेल्थ प्रोडक्ट्स आल्सो, आई कुड सी अ वैरायटी ऑफ थिंग्स दैट कैन हेल्प अ पर्सन टू यू नो गेट बैक हेयर एंड हेयर लॉस विद हेयर हेल्थ. बट वन थिंग इज फॉर श्योर, आप बिना किसी मतलब सप्लीमेंट खाली अकेले काम नहीं कर सकते आपके लिए. इफ यू आर स्लीप डिप्राइव, इफ टूडे योर फिजिकल हेल्थ इज नॉट गुड, you're mentally really exhausted, you know, you don't have enough amount of protein or micronutrients and macronutrients in your body. So har ek cheez ki ek balance hona bahut zaruri hai. And with that, there's something that I've been working on, and that is metal toxicity. So how does this work? I will tell you very simple things here. The kind of aluminium that we use in our diet, like to just to, you know, use, like wrap our food. First thing is that. Second is the kind of cosmetics we've started using. A lot of lead is present in those cosmetics. Then the kind of pesticides and all those things that we are, you know, having the environment right now into. So these things contribute to extra metals in our body, and those metals could obviously create a sense of, जैसे आप देखेंगे कई लोगों को acne कुछ ज्यादा हो जाते हैं, with few hair coloring, there are some people who get allergic. These are signs that your body is probably not able to take those metals and you need to excrete out those metals. तो यहाँ पे बहुत simple सी चीज होती है कि what we do for a person, if you want to switch onto any supplement or any kind of, you know, good diet, first measure your BCA, that is your body composition analysis. Understand how your body looks like and what does it require to eliminate and obviously re-inoculate. That means aap kis cheez ko flush out karenge and kis cheez ko inoculate karenge. That is very important. Aap kuch bhi soch ke mat lijiye ki aaj aapne ek, you know, omega oil ka ek tab kha liya, kal ek biotin ka kha liya, kal ek magnesium ka kha liya. It's not going to work like that. See what are the levels, see what are the optimum levels, work on them, research a little bit on them, ask your doctor to advise you, and then continue with these supplements, because until unless it's not going to work. So even metal toxicity is something that very less people are talking. The kind of, you know, even the water quality nowadays, we are seeing so different variety of things. Kangen water is coming now. So I can see so many things, but definitely a good diet, hydration, and 15 to 20 minutes of movement is super important for your body to make, you know, ample amount of good hormones for your hair also and for your skin also.
Right. That's absolutely a right point that you have, you know, mentioned here, that people take the supplements but are not ready to change their lifestyles. So lifestyle is a very important role. And I feel somehow our entire body is governed and like it's working how our gut health is. It's totally based on health, because our body heat, be it skin, be it hair, be it our internal health, be it diabetes, everything is connected to the food, what we eat, and how our gut is taking all of those things, right?
Yeah. So Ridhima, what I personally feel is people are not giving enough amount of rest to their bodies. Trust me, it happens with me also. If I'm under pressure, if I'm under stressed, I'm not eating properly, I'm not sleeping properly, acne would come up. my hair won't perform that much good. I will see a lot of changes in my body. And this needs to be told to everyone that if you are compressing your body into a state of environment where your body is not able to, you know, feel good or maybe be open to what it has to perform, anything won't work. Like, not just hair health, but definitely aapki immunity kitna down ho jati hai. Right now, even we saw this one thing ki aap agar post-vaccination or pre-vaccination sleep deprived ja rahe hain, even the efficacy of vaccines also have decreased, right? So this is similar to our body. If you'll pressurize your body, if you'll keep your body under stress, you are not excreting out what you have been feeling or maybe what your gut has been into a state. I think that's the time where you need to understand ki agar aapki gut health mein issues aa rahe hain, constipation hai, diarrhea hai, ab probiotics add karo. Start having a little bit of...
Sorry, you're not audible. Yeah.
Actually, I got a call in between. Sorry. Yeah, now is it fine?
Yes.
So this is one thing, and I think for the diet, a lot of people have questions related to intermittent fasting. We first need to see what kind of body you have, because telling you today that intermittent fasting would give you a good result, I don't believe in that, because reason being, there are 90% of people who have worked with intermittent fasting. We don't deny it, but there is a way to go. There is first a way to understand your body, of which all factors your body fit into. Once you understand what is your body mass, what is your body water, and everything related to that, after that we work upon few things ki aapko kaun si diet leni chahiye. And this is best prescribed by a nutritionist, because she knows how much amount and kitni amount mein aapka ek nutrient jana chahiye, and kitni amount mein aapko ek product khana. Matlab khane ka bhi na, what I feel, itne sare fat diets and itni sab cheeze ho gayi hain is time pe, people are confused. They are reading on YouTube ki intermittent fasting bahut acha hai. बट इंटरमीडियट फास्टिंग को स्टार्ट करने के बाद आपको कैसा फील होता है आफ्टर 16 आवर्स ऑफ फास्टिंग एंड हाउ यू विल सस्टेन योर बॉडी इनटू दैट स्टेट इज इम्पोर्टेंट. आप स्टार्ट तो कर लोगे, बट वेयर यू विल एंड, दैट्स द क्वेश्चन.
राइट, एंड वी हैव दिस वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चन. डू यू वांट टू टेक इट अप मैम? इज देयर अ वे टू हेल्प विद पीसीओएस सिम्टम्स थ्रू योर गट?
डेफिनेटली. आई थिंक वंस यू करेक्ट योर गट हेल्थ, योर पीसीओएस कैन बी रिवर्स्ड. It's not something, obviously it cannot be cured, as we say. It's reversible nowadays. We're seeing people, you know, going back to the same thing. But your diet plays a very important role, because you are insulin resistant at that point of time. You gain a lot of weight. So I have seen people who are working on their, you know, weight gain issues also there. Once they start working on their weight, their hormones, their diet, I think things come back into picture. And this is with everything. This is with every other condition that you're going through in your body. Aapki body mein koi bhi aaj chronic illness hai, you just need to figure out the root cause. Once you know ki kis cheez ki wajah se wo aggravate ho raha hai, what are the disruptors at that point of time, you will stop them, you will block them, and you'll start working on the good part of it. So just start understanding your body. I think hum log itne mindful abhi hai hi nahi. Even with COVID, people also, what I could see, there was a panic around. Nobody was trying to understand ki COVID patient constipation mein bhi ja sakta hai, ya fir too much of diarrhea state mein bhi ja sakta hai. We were just, you know, randomly we were just trying to give that person a lot of antibiotics. I have literally made it possible for, I think, 10 COVID patients who were given good amount of probiotics while the time they were on antibiotics. And that helped them recover back, because if today you are in a state of constipation or diarrhea, trust me, you're going to end up losing a lot of electrolytes, or maybe you will be just constipated from inside, and that would not create a good feeling. And there the problem starts. You will start multiplying a lot of conditions while you are constipated. So you need to work on what has to be taken in the pre and the pro, both the sides. Ridhima, I cannot hear you.
Sorry, can you hear me now?
Yeah.
So somebody asked how constipation can be controlled.
Sorry, what's the question?
How constipation can be controlled?
See, again, this depends what kind of, you know, diet you're having. High fiber diet is very important. You should have a lot of protein into your diet. Hydration, super important. make sure you're having enough amount of antioxidants also. So I don't state food products in any sessions, because there are so many people who are allergic to different things nowadays. So once you start telling that go for soya, and now if suppose I know this person is allergic to soya, now this creates a trouble. So you just figure out what kind of diet you have to go, talk to your doctor, tell her or him that these are all the things that I've been allergic to, or maybe this doesn't suit me. There's so many people jinko diet dairy products se bhi I think acne is trigger hote hain. So there we need to understand ki aapko ye suit kar raha hai and you have to go for this. But antioxidants like vitamin A, E, then sometimes selenium, these are few I think nobody's been talking about it, and I shall soon be putting out the content over these also, because little bit of vitamins and minerals are missing right now. Like vitamin K, nobody talks about it. Biotin is something that we don't take usually. Vitamin D is not secreted well in our bodies. So these are things which a normal person should include, knowing their values. If they are on an optimal level, definitely go for a 1 week of course and stop it there. But if you are high or low on them, then we need to figure out how we will make the entire plan for them.
Right. So another question which is very interesting, and so we have a lot of customers who are vegetarians, and here we have which asks if vegetarians have to lift heavy and work out extensively, is it okay for them to consume whey protein? Because they come up with a lot of rumors and myths that it affects gut health and body overall.
I think there is this one thing, and it's very simple, something that's very tough for our gut to kind of break down and digest. Always will make it impossible for your gut to perform its action, right? So anything that is a little bit, if you feel you are start taking it for a day or so, just see if you're able to have a good bowel movement, you're able to excrete it out, whatever you're eating. And this depends, whey protein is something I personally feel aap whey protein ke sath kya le rahe hain pre and post, that depends a lot. Because if you're only taking whey protein, I'm sure your kidneys are not going to do well. Like you will soon end up into some trouble because of too much of whey protein. But if it's excreted out in a proper way with proper hydration and food, so I think that then it could work.
Okay, somebody has asked dietary sources for and supplements for vitamins A, D, E, and K.
Okay, so she's included everything. Okay, so just wonder that I say this to all, okay. We are living in such a beautiful country, trust me. I don't know why people don't talk about it, but reason being because we are not mindful of what the nature is giving us outside. It reflects a kind of it gives us a kind of message when it's morning, when it's evening, and when it's night, right? So we need to work on that pattern first thing. That is a circadian rhythm that we need to follow first thing, that a lot of people don't do. Second, people have just known this factor that these are certain vitamins and minerals jo hume khane hain, we will pop up and things are going to get better. It's never going to happen, trust me. Supplements aapki sirf ek upar se jo ek we say this one thing na, it will keep on filling, but you will never know what is just underneath, what is on the root. You will never get to know, and one day you will end up having too much of supplements which is not going to cost you anything. So there are things like vitamin A, D, E, K that she has asked. So A is something you can get from a good amount of balanced diet, leafy vegetables, carrots. Everything has been so colorful with the nature that we can extract from that, and we can have, trust me, I have everything. Today people ask me what do you have, and I say literally I'm having ghee and everything in my diet, too much in the COVID times also. Reason being because why we are stopping ourselves to make our bodies go through each and everything, because hum starting se hi itna restrict kar lete hain apne aap ko, now that we become resistant, right? And once we become resistant, later on if you're having that thing after 5 years, you're going to have a problem. You're definitely going to land in a problem. So give everything in a minute amount to your body and make sure it's a colored thing. There are so many colors, there are different colors that even vegetables and fruits have been giving. So A, D, E, K all covers up. If you're having spinach, if you're having broccoli, lauki, then different things. I think our ancestors used to tell us ki aap ye khao, but now that we are least concerned, we are more concerned with what the Zomato is coming with, or maybe what is the offer going on. सो वी नीड टू स्टॉप देयर एंड वी नीड टू सी कि घर में बहुत सारी चीजें हैं ऐसी ऑलरेडी, राइट? आई थिंक लॉट ऑफ क्वेश्चंस हैव पॉपड अप.
Yeah, that's what I was just going through. So, there's this question about biotin. So, you know, in India, people have this one notion in their mind and they're not ready to move from that thing that taking supplements will harm them. It's like taking medicines for lifelong. Even they resist multivitamins and other supplements. So, do you think it has any effect on the gut health, like taking biotin or something for a longer duration?
See, anything taken for a longer time obviously would have adverse effects over there. I don't think so. Depends on the lifestyle of the person also. Depends on what the person is currently having, if any other medical conditions also are there. If you are, you know, you need to understand the process our gut health goes through. Agar aapko wo cheez samajh aati hai, then definitely you can make it easy for even biotin to, you know, work in a good way. Right now what we are doing is we are just giving supplements, we are bombarding ourselves, and our hormones are actually, you know, being flooded up and down, up and down, and we are not able to control that. So biotin is not wrong, no supplement is bad until unless it's, you know, being taken in the, you know, unbalanced way. So I think you can go for it, but 5 to 6 months depends, like why do you need that much?
Right. So I feel taking a supervision of a doctor, consulting a doctor would be the best option to take any supplements, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So with Raya also, customers are coming in and we are constantly supervising their treatment. It is backed by doctors. So that is what we are also to convey, that it is very important that whatever you take is backed by science. Someone is looking after
it. Yeah.
Because there are so many brands that have come up and the marketing...
Too many.
Yeah, marketing technology. You see, there's so many things, best for this, best for that. And people just randomly start taking those supplements or the products available.
This is also going on, like just this person asked about whey protein. So it has happened. A lot of people, they will order it and they feel ki order karke, like once you start popping them without knowing what is there in your body. See, our body is made up of chemicals, hormones, cells, and these are working 24 hours. We are not giving our bodies rest, trust me. And adding on to this, if you're additionally adding supplements, now your body needs more attention. And that's the time you need to work on what you are having and what you're excreting.
We have this really interesting question. Is it normal eating a meal and then passing stool within an hour? Is it normal or what can be done in such cases?
So it depends what you're eating. If you had something like, you know, too much of ghee or something, like it acts as a laxative, right? So yeah, in an hour, if it's happening too much frequently, like I'll say if it's happening every 1 ghante ke baad fir se ho gaya, then that's a problem. Then that there you need to report. But if it's happening like this and you are passing stools like 2 to 3 in a day, it's that's fine.
Right.
इतना कॉम्प्लिकेट कर दिया हम लोगों ने साइंस को. आई थिंक वी नीड टू यू नो गो बैक टू व्हाट आवर एंसेस्टर्स यूज्ड टू डू, राइट? एंड वी आर नॉट डूइंग दैट बिकॉज ऑफ दैट वन थिंग व्हिच इज द आई थिंक थंब रूल, राइट? कि सब कुछ खाओ बट अंडरस्टैंड दैट हर चीज को एक लिमिट में खाना है.
या And again, like you said, it depends on the body type and what your body is accepting. So people should be aware of their own bodies while taking in what.
Okay, somebody has written, you both are sisters.
Yeah, I see a lot of comments there saying, why do you look so similar? Mukul has asked, if we take more amounts of vitamins than body needs, will that amount be secreted out? I've checked for water-soluble vitamins. It does, but still he has a doubt.
If we take more amount of vitamins than body need, will that amount be secreted out? If you're taking more than what your body is demanding, definitely it's going to convert into a lethal way. Like obviously it's going to show up in some signs and symptoms, and you need to observe. Like you need to observe your color of urine, something like if you're feeling any kind of uneasiness, like your tongue color also, your eye color. So there are specific things our body tells in a very smarter way. And you know, a body has already got those systems where it will tell you and give you, you know, kind of idea ki abhi is time pe there's something going wrong, right? So we need to be very much vigilant once we start with something and start observing these signs and symptoms. If you're feeling something like that, then definitely you need to, you know, go to a doctor and talk about that.
Right. So I feel I've taken up the questions that have come so far.
It is will there, keep on coming.
Yeah. So is there any point that we might have not covered in the questions or earlier in the session?
So I think the last point that I would talk about here is that please understand that aapki body ek system se work karti hai. It's not going to happen if you're popping pills and if you're expecting that your body would, you know, come today with a glowy skin and with good long hair. And, you know, there's so many girls who ask me, ki mujhe Rapunzel jaise hair chahiye. I want the skin like, you know, too much of glowing and all that. And I'm like, okay, are you really even, you know, mindful of what you're eating and giving to your body? They've never even thought of this thing ki jab hum khana khate hain, we are not even looking at our food. We're just in so much rush, trust me. And I have started giving myself so much time when I eat. And my mother is really shouting from the behind, ki, how long do you take to eat food? And I'm like, I don't take long, but definitely I enjoy the food. And nowadays what is happening is we're just eating for the sake of maybe gratification. People have been doing it since long, since the time social media also has come up. I can see people taking pictures, not enjoying the food, keeping other things aside, and they're eating after, you know, 15-20 minutes. Small kids, they've started doing, just, you know, because being mindful over everything, even your body, even the food, everything has got energy. And I really, you know, believe in this one thing, ki agar aap kisi cheez ko kha rahe ho, or maybe if you are today probably breathing also, it's a sort of probably it's a sort of mechanism our body has developed for us, and we need to focus on that. Because wo aapko apni jagah se alag leke jata hai. Like, you need to focus what you are eating and what you're picking from the market also. What we are doing is we're just looking at kaun sa product hai, market mein kaun sa acha chal raha hai, just go for that and you'll be all good. It doesn't happen like that.
Right. So there's this one question of body LDL. I'm not sure what that is.
So it's something as low density lipoprotein. Basically, it's for hypertension only. But see, again, comes back to here. If you are not eating well, your cholesterol levels, your diabetes, obviously your kidney levels, your liver levels are going to fluctuate. And this has been since the very start. Har koi doctor ye bolta hai ki aap apni diet pe dhyan dijiye. And this is because aap jo bhi khate hain, it reflects on your levels. And if you don't, if you started ignoring those, you know, signs and symptoms, it's going to get worsened with time. So if today you're having hair loss, if today you're having some sort of skin issues, you started having acne for no reason, there might be something that is going wrong in your body. It cannot be ever ki aapke sath kuch hua and your body has nothing to show off. It's always there. You just need to track it.
Perfect. So should we be wrapping up with our session or
I hope you're done with your session.
Right, so we got a really nice interaction from the audiences as well. So I would really like to thank everyone who joined. And the questions were really interesting and you explained it so well. So we also got a lot of questions about minoxidil DHT. And definitely we'll be doing another session with our dermatologist about that. So no worries, guys, on this thing. So we just wanted to focus on the gut health today with Dr. Samrithi. And we'll definitely look forward to more sessions, ma'am. It was really nice having you with
us. Definitely. Thank you, Ridhima, for just making a day much more insightful for me and even the audience today. Thank you.
Thanks, guys. Thank you, ma'am. Have a good day.